Hey everybody, once again I have returned for another reaction to some interesting music. This has been suggested to me today by Vivi Alita, I'm going with. This is the name of the channel anyway. And they've suggested, I'm not sure if it's a man or a woman, but they've suggested Astor Piazzolla with a song called Libertango. And I believe that's the tango style of music. It sounds obvious from the name of the song. And also, I believe this is a player of the bandoneon. I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but it's, apparently it's an accordion that replicates the sound of church music. I think this is what I've gathered from what people have told me. So this is going to be different for me. It's going to be interesting. I did hear a bit of bandoneon in, I think it was a Spinetta song, or it could have been an Invisible song. And I was like, oh, what's that? I couldn't work out if it was an accordion or if it was a harmonica. And people were saying, it's a bandoneon. I can't remember how to say it. I don't know. But I think this is what this guy's playing. I've seen one picture of him holding this accordion type thing. So let's just go straight onto it and check it out, because I'm interested to hear it. I'm interested to hear it all. Hear a full song of bandoneon, is that what it's called? I don't know. Let's just find the right video. Right, and let's play. Because I want to have a chat about it halfway through, I remember. Well, yeah, that's the bandoneon. I'll go with bandoneon. It's like an accordion, a squeeze box kind of thing. I'm getting some guitar, like just like it could be a bass going boom, ba-dum, ba-dum, like it's kind of like a repetitive kind of bass kind of beat. And there's a little bit of, you know, drums, you've got the nice little bits like snare, hi-hat kind of action going on, just nice, slowly giving it the tempo. But the main instrument is the sounds of the squeeze box, the bandoneon. Yeah, I think you've got two noises coming from that, because you've got the one noise, because it plays, does it not play two different like notes at the same time? So it'll play one note like constantly, like a ooh, kind of backgroundy noise, and then you make extra noises with so it's like you've got like two sounds, I think, emanating, one from the squeezing that produces one sound and another sound produced by the because I can kind of feel that I can hear like a noise which I'm assuming is the bandoneon. And then another noise also sent out, I imagine, is the bandoneon. So I'm assuming like I'm sure these accordions can make two kind of noises. It plays like a tone as well as making a rhythm at the same time. I'm sure that's what these kind of accordions can do. I'm not, don't quote me on that, because I have never played one in my life. I used to, when I was a kid, I used to do some with my brother, but I went with him a couple of times. We did some like traditional kind of Morris dancing, English dancing, and someone there had an accordion, a squeeze box, and I'm sure it makes a noise on the in and out, as well as another noise when you're playing the finger in the buttons. So I think I'm picking up both those kind of noises there. It's I'm imagining this is what they dance the tango to. This kind of rhythm would be for the tango. I can imagine the feet sweeping around as people are spinning around on the dance floor kind of thing. But to listen to it, there's no singing. Obviously, it doesn't seem like there's going to be any singing. But it's just, it's a nice kind of like lively little sort of stuff. And also, because it's like an instrument that I've not heard a great deal, it's interesting to listen to like a new instrument for me, practically. You don't see the squeeze ball, the accordion, hardly ever, really, do you? It's more of a folk instrument, isn't it? It's more of like a country sort of instrument, like a traditional instrument. I think quite a lot of countries have got their own version of that kind of squeeze box kind of device. I think they're quite big in Germany, aren't they? I'm not too sure. And I got a feeling we used them in Britain as well, and maybe in America. I get a feeling they might use it in America, like in, the bluegrass, maybe. I'm not too sure, actually. I don't really know. I'm not too familiar with the history and usage of the accordion through history or through various music from around the world. But yeah, it's interesting. It kind of reminds me as well. I was thinking, like, the sound, for some reason, I could picture this being like a movie score, like or a TV show. Like, it sounds almost like Mission Impossible. I don't know, just the sort of build-up of it. Like, I can just picture this being like a spy TV show where something's going down and they're like, they're sneaking into the evil bad genius's base and they're sneaking around trying not to be found by the enemy. I don't know, something about the sound of it, it's almost got like an anticipation kind of sound, like something's going to happen. It's just, I don't know, it's that kind of air. Maybe it's just the instrument maybe the instrument lends itself to that kind of suspense and intrigue. But maybe I'm just talking nonsense. Let's just finish up the song. It's not a very long one. Interesting guitar playing there. Was it charango? Was it a charango that was playing there? I think that's the name of the instrument, like the little tiny guitar. But there was some interesting picking going on there, like going behind, like it added its own kind of element to the song. I still can't get over thinking that sounds like it should belong in a spy drama, in some kind of, spy TV show or spy film. It just had that kind of air of like urgency about it somehow, that song. It's like, I can just imagine people like, running away from, from bad guys with guns while that music's playing. Just something about the tone of it. Maybe the sound of the instrument adds itself or lends itself to that kind of, I think I already sort of said this, like anticipation, that kind of air of danger almost. I don't know, maybe just my imagination on that bit there. But yeah, that was interesting. I enjoyed that. It was like very lively, very kind of interesting. I don't know, it wasn't so much, it was kind of like, wasn't like a mellow rhythm. It kind of was mellow, but it was something about the do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. It made it sound like energetic, like not quite like dance, so I imagine this tango, you spin around doing the tango to it, but tango is like a slower, kind of more beautiful dance, isn't it? I think, where you're kind of like gliding gracefully, like in circles and all that kind of stuff. It's not one of the ones that's super fast dance, at least I don't think it is. But yeah, for some reason, I could just the tone of it, the rhythm of it, it made me think of, I don't know, it just made me think of not danger or getting away from danger. I don't know. It was like an air of trepidation, an air of trepidation about it. I don't know why. Maybe it's just the tone of the instruments. It gives it like, it's like kind of like it's not like a soft, mellow kind of like dreamy kind of. It's more like, dude, it's kind of like it's got that sort of energy that kind of like keeps you sort of slightly alert. It's got like an alert kind of sound, like it's a sound that like perks you up. And you know, if you maybe you don't know, I can't kind of express it, but it's not like a really laid back where you can just go. It's one of the ones. It's like the energy of it makes you sort of. It feels like a lively song, a song to be energetic to, you know, a song to, I think it's the band Odeon, the sound of the band Odeon, that kind of like rhythmic, that lively rhythm that it's got going on. Like I can, you know, feel you kind of like, you know, rather than drifting off to it, more like paying attention because it demands your attention because it's playing that kind of lively kind of do 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 do. But you know, that's just my first impression. I mean, I may be completely and utterly wrong. I mean, what do you guys think? Am I talking out of my backside again? But yeah, no, that was good fun. I enjoyed that. That was an interesting track. I thought I heard some strings at one point. Were there some other strings involved in that, or was that done by the Bandodian? I'm sure there was, like, at one point, I thought I heard like some strings coming, like a little string section. I don't think it was like guitar. Or a charango, whatever it was. It sounded like, I don't know, some cello or something. I thought for a second, unless that was somehow the Bandodian, or maybe it was my imagination. I don't know. But yeah, that was cool. That was an interesting one to check out. Yeah. And a few people have asked me to check out Astor Piazzolla. That one was actually requested by Vivre Elita, a channel called Vivre Elita. So cheers for that. And if you want to tell me anything about that track, tell me anything about my reaction, my talking nonsense, or my kind of like, oh yeah, I see what you mean. If you've got any of your own comments, any of suggestions, leave them down below. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you want to help the channel out, there are links down below. You can support me if you wish to. I won't carry on. Just say cheers, and I'll be back tomorrow. Or as we say in the Spanish-speaking countries of the world, gracias por mira, vuelva mañana para otro video. Bye.